Let's go to ICRA to continue with our integration classes. And in this lecture of integration, we will discuss integration involving quadratic with square root of quadratic terms. So, yes, student A. So, we will study quadratic with square root of quadratic. So, the quadratic and square root of quadratic both in numerator as well as in denominator. Yeah, wait, I'm going to tell you. Okay, so see here. There is only one form where the integration can be done, where q has all x square, this x square, then x and the constant terms. So only one form is possible where integration is possible, where q has all x square, x and constant terms. And in other terms also integration is possible, but the q will not involve all the x square, x and constant terms. It will involve maybe only x square and constant like this. So we'll see in detail. So we'll start with this particular form, and that form is integration of q1 upon square root of q2, where q1 is one quadratic and q2 is another quadratic. So can anybody tell me how to proceed? I have one quadratic in the numerator and another quadratic in the denominator. Anybody? Yeah, student B. So we have one quadratic numerator, so we can express the numerator quadratic in terms of the denominator quadratic so that the things get simplified. Exactly. So I will express q1 in terms of q2. And how can I do that? I can say that q1 is equal to a times q2, but this will not be complete. So I will write then another constant b and q2 dash. This is the way we do. We put introduce another constant b and q2 dash because it will be linear. And then again constant maybe not set, we will not be able to match. So we will put another c here. So the thing is that the substitution for this is q1 is equal to a q2 plus b q2 dash then plus c. Q2 dash is differentiation of the denominator q2. So the integration becomes, in numerator I have a q2 plus b q2 dash plus c, and denominator I have another q2. Now it gets simplified. So what it becomes? A, this q2 upon square root of q2, this becomes square root of q2 in numerator. Then in b, it is easy. This is q2 dash upon square root of q2. And in c, I have 1 upon under root of q2. Now, the things are very easy now. If you see this, this is what we have studied in our previous lecture. This is of square root of quadratic form. So this is square root of quadratic form, and what is the answer for this? We know that the answer for this is the standard, and it is x by 2 square root of quadratic, then plus or plus minus a square by 2 integration of 1 by root q that we have remembered. Now this one we will see, the second part I call it as I2, integration I2. Then this third part, this one also, it is, this is standard form, 1 by root q form. And what is the answer for 1 by root q form? We know that it will be either sine inverse or log, depending on the sign, plus minus sign. So it will be either sine inverse or log. So this is also standard form. So only we have to worry about this middle form I2. So I will solve this I2 form. And in I2, I have b integration of q2 dash upon q2 dx. Now it's very easy. Can anybody help me? So yes, student J. Sir, I have in numerator q dash and denominator square root of q2. So it's very simple. I substitute in the denominator q2 equal to any constant set t, and then differentiate, numerator becomes dt. Yeah, exactly true. But it will be better if I substitute q2 as t square. You see the beauty that it will be very helpful if I substitute q2 as t square, then q2 dash will become 2t dt. So what happens in C? It is simply very easily. So in numerator, now q2 dash dx, this whole numerator, it becomes 2t dt. Okay, so I get 2t dt. And denominator, I have q2 t square. So square root of q2 will be t. I get t here, and t gets cancelled. And I get 2t dt, and the answer is 2bt. After integrate, I get 2bt. So I2 is simplified into very simple form. Thus, we are able to solve q1 upon under root of q2 form where Q involves all the x square, x and constant terms. Okay, so what should I do now? So let us take an example, and this is of the form Q1 upon square root of Q2 form. So in numerator I have one quadratic and in denominator I have another quadratic, and I will proceed. So what should I do? I will write numerator as denominator, in terms of denominator, aq2 dash plus bq2 plus c. So aq2 plus bq2 dash plus c, x square plus 5x plus 1 is equal to a, q2 is x square plus 1, then bq2 dash. So what is my q2 dash? This is my x square, so q2 dash will be 2x. So I get a 2x and then constant. Now how I find the value of a? See, the method to find the values of a, b and c is by comparing the coefficients of x square, x and the constant. So here the coefficient of x square is what? 1. So, and also here the coefficient of x square is a. So if I compare the coefficient of x square, I get the value of a is equal to 1. Now if I compare the coefficient of x, so on my left hand side my coefficient of x is 5 and my right hand side it is 2b, so I get 2b is equal to 5, so I get value of b is equal to 5 by 2. Now to find the value of c, I will compare the constant term. The constant term on my left hand side is 1 and on my right hand side it is this 1 into a then plus c. I have a plus c, so this is my constant term on the right hand side, and my value of a is 1, so I get the value of c equal to 0. So I get the value of a equal to 1 and b equal to 5 by 2 and c equal to 0. So I don't have any c term now. So this becomes easy also. So this integration x square plus 5x plus 1 upon under root of x square plus 1 becomes a q2 plus b q2 dash, and c is 0, so I don't have c here now. Now it gets very simplified. It becomes a square root of q2 plus b q2 dash upon square root of q2 dx plus constant. And square root of q2 is what? We remembered in the, we studied in the last lecture that it is x by 2 square root of q plus a square by 2, and this will become not sine inverse, this will become log. So this becomes x by 2 square root of q, so this is x by 2 and square root of q in denominator, plus a square by 2, a is 1, so this half, and I get here log x plus under root x square plus 1. This is the standard form. And q2 dash upon q root q2, we have studied that I will put this is equal to t square, then this will become 2t dt and the answer will be 2bt. So this is 2bt square root of x square plus 1. So this was very easy. If we have understood that whenever we have q by square root of q form, we have to write aq2 plus bq2 dash plus c, and the things get simplified. Now when we have quadratic with square root of quadratic, we have two more special forms. But remember, I told you before that there is only one form where the q has all the terms. Here the special forms of q will not have all the terms, we will see. And the form is, I have one quadratic here and another quadratic here. In denominator, both are in denominator, and here I don't have any x term, only x square and constant. X square and constant, so I don't have any x term. So remember, this is the only case where the integration is possible. If x is there, then integration is difficult. So here, this is the, in the syllabus, and remember this form, integration of dx upon ax square plus b and c square plus d form. So what I have to do here, one of our previous student, his name was Sipten, he found a very good method to solve this integration, and the method is that from the first quadratic form, take x square common out. Take x square common out. Similarly, from the second quadratic form also, take the x square common out. So this x square will be get out as x square, and this x square will get out as x, because this is in square root. I have square root here, so this x square will come out as x. So if I take this first x square out, I get here, this is my x square, and a plus b by x square, and again here x square gets out and becomes x, and then c plus d by x square. So the integration becomes x cube a plus b x square c d plus under root of c plus d upon x square. Now what should I do? Anybody can think that what should I do so that the things get simplified? Anybody? I have in denominator x cube, then I have something upon x square, something upon x square, and something upon x cube. So any hint? Sure. Yes, student E. So I have 1 by x cube dx. So if I put 1 by x square equal to t, then I will get 1 by x cube dx is equal to t. Yeah, correct approach. But I can simplify it better. Let's see what I can do. You told me that I put this thing as t, so that this thing, whole thing upon 1 upon x cube dx, this whole thing will become dt. Okay, that is good approach. But in order to simplify further, I can do like this. I will put this whole thing as t square, and the things gets much simplified. So I put c plus d x square whole thing as t square. Why t square? Because this is in square root. So I will put c plus d upon x square is equal to t square. Then if I differentiate, I'll get 1 upon x square is minus 2 upon x cube dx is equal to dt. So what will happen? That this thing dx upon x cube will become this simplified thing. So this dx upon this x cube, this thing, whole thing will become simplified. And I got the value of in 1 upon x square in denominator, so I can get this value also simplified. So things get very easily. So let's see what happens. 1 upon x cube dx, I can put this minus t by t dt. Then this thing from here, I will calculate the value of 1 by x square. I get the value of 1 by x square. And then I put the value of 1 by x square here, so that I get value of a plus b by x square. So I get the value of a plus b by x square is equal to a plus b, and then I put the value of 1 by x square. So finally I got all the values. I got this thing, then I got this thing, and I got this thing. Okay, so this thing, the whole thing becomes t, this whole thing becomes this thing, and 1 by x cube dx becomes minus t dt. So things are very simplified now. So here I put all the three values. So 1 by x cube will become this thing, and this thing, whole thing becomes this t, and this whole thing, it becomes this thing. Now what will happen? My t gets cancelled and things will get simplified, and I will have in denominator I will have quadratic form. So this will be ad plus bt2 square minus c. So this is actually 1 by q form. And anybody remember what is integration of 1 by q form? Anybody? Yes, student B. So 1 by q form, when we integrate, we will get either tan inverse or log. Yeah. So we will get either tan inverse or log. So now let's take an example for this. This is of the special form where I have both quadratic in denominator, one is in square root, and I don't have any x term. There is no x term. So I will use the Siftin's method. Siftin was our student, where we take this x square out and also this x square out. So what will happen? I will take this x square out and also x square out from this square root, and I get this thing. I further simplify, this becomes x cube, 1 plus 1 by x square and 1 plus 2 by x square. And if you remember what I have done, I have put all this thing as t square, and things get simplified. So if I put 1 plus t square, 2 by x square is a t square, then after differentiating I get minus 4 by x cube dx is equal to 2 dt. So I get the value of 1 by x cube, and I put all the values. I will put the value of this. So from here, this thing becomes t here, and this 1 by x cube dx, I get this value. And for 1 plus 1 by x square, if I simplify, I get this particular value. Now if I simplify further, I get minus half t dt upon 1 plus t square minus 1 by 2 t into whole t, and this t gets cancelled. So in numerator I will have 1 by q form, and the q form is minus of integration of dt upon t square plus 1. So what is integration of t square plus 1? Anybody remembers? 1 upon x square plus a square form. This is 1 upon q form. Yes, student A. Sir, 1 by q form, 1 upon x square plus a square is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So here 1 by a tan inverse x by a, here will be 1 upon 1 and 10 square t upon 1. Yeah, correct. So this will be 10 square t, and t is what we have substituted. So I will put back the value of t, and I get minus of 10 inverse square root of 1 plus 2 by x square plus constant. Okay. Now let's see the another special form where q with a root of q, and again here I don't have any x term, I have only x square term and constant term, also both in numerator and denominator, and in numerator I have square root of quadratic. And remember, I have told you before also that whenever you have square root of quadratic in numerator, remember in numerator, then rationalize the numerator. This is the way in integration. So whenever you have square root of quadratic in numerator, rationalize the numerator. So here when I rationalize, I get ax square plus b, and then square root will comes down in the denominator. Now what next? Can anybody help me? What should I do so that things get simplified? Sir, yes, Rindy. Sir, in numerator I have one quadratic and denominator I have another quadratic, and as before, as usual, and which is also the standard, that I substitute the quadratic in numerator in terms of the denominator. Oh yeah, exactly. This is what we do. So here I will express this ax square plus b in terms of this, in terms of the denominator. This is already the same, these two are the same. So I will express this particular in terms of this quadratic. So what can I do? I can say that ax square plus b is equal to a q2 plus b q2 dash plus c. But I don't need q2 dash. Remember, not this thing here, because I don't have any x term, so I don't need q2 dash. So this is the simplified thing here, and the beauty of this thing is that I will not need q2 dash. So I will just say a q2, so q2 q1 by a q2 plus b, constant only, no q2 dash. So, and I will find the values of a and b by comparing the coefficients. And now see the word, how the things get simplified. So this will becomes, in numerator I will have a q2 plus b, and for the simplification I get this c square plus d gets cancelled for the first term. So I will get 1 upon square root of a square plus b dx, and for the second integral I will get this whole thing. So I get this whole thing in the second integral. Okay, I am written here b, both b same, this is small b by mistake, it is b. This b is different than this b here. Okay. So what is this? This is 1 by square root of q form. And anybody remember what is the integration of 1 by square root q? Nobody? 1 by square root of q? Yes, student E. So 1 by square root of q is either sine inverse or log. Yeah, that's true. Either sine inverse or log. So depending on the sign of this. Oh, okay, see, this b is different than this b. This is typing mistake, so this is small b. Then here, this will be the two-way form, which we have just solved. We have just solved before. Q, this q upon square root of q, and where, sorry, 1 upon q into square root of q, where q does not have x term. So we have already solved this type of problem. So, and the things get simplified. So let's take an example. I have square root of quadratic in numerator and x square minus 1 in denominator. So this is of my 2b form. And what I do, I will rationalize the numerator. And I will get here in denominator x square plus 1. Now I will express the numerator in terms of denominator. I don't always have to write a and b and c. I can also use logic. So I want to express this x square plus 1 in terms of x square minus 1. So I can say this is x square minus 1 plus 2. So this is in terms of denominator only. This x square minus 1 is same as this. So x square plus 1 I can write as x square minus 1 plus 2. So I have expressed this in terms of the denominator. So things get simplified, and I get here the first integral is 1 upon square root of q. This is 1 by q form, and the second is my 2a form. So this is 1 by root q form, which will become either sine inverse or log, and this one is my 2a form, and things get very easily simplified. So this is my 1 by root q form, and this is my 2a form, which we have already solved before. And this, thus I hope that you have understood all the quadratic with square root of quadratic forms. And I repeat that whenever I have q1 upon square root of q2, then I can have all the x square, x and constant terms. Then in the two special forms, I will not have x terms, I will have only x square and the constant term. And in one of the special forms, I have both the quadratic in the denominator And the second special form, I have square root of quadrate in the numerator and I rationalize the numerator. So I hope all of you have understood. Is the concept clear to all of you? Yes, sir. Thank you.